To export a video in DaVinci Resolve, the first thing we must do is go to the delivery module. In this icon with a rocket drawn, once we enter, we see that at the top there are different export presets. For YouTube, H.264, H.265. Export the project to use in Final Cut or Premiere. I only recommend using these settings to export the videos quickly. And if you are not interested in exporting with the highest quality, but in this tutorial I am going to teach you how to make your own adjustments manually. To have a control of all the options, we must click on the custom icon. The first step is to give your video a name. In this case, I am going to call it Nature. Now you must choose where on your computer you want to save the video file. I am going to export it here, on the desktop. We press Save. Now we are going to select which part of the video we want to export. Everything that is below this gray bar is the part of the project that is going to be exported. Press the I key to mark the video input. And we press the O key to mark the video output. Now it is only going to export this part that I have selected. But I want to export the entire video. So I mark the input in the beginning of the video and mark the output just when it ends. Make sure that you have done it correctly, since many times there are frames of the video without selecting. For this you can zoom and fix it. Once we have finished, we go with the export settings. In the render section, we can select an individual clip or clips. In individual clips, a video of this clip will be exported. Another video of this, other, another and another. If we select the option of a clip, it will only export a video with all of them together. Knowing this, we select the way we want and go a format. I recommend using the MP4 format. The QuickTime format is similar, but in my experience it can cause problems when uploading the video on social networks or web pages. And now we must choose between the H.264 or H.265. The H.264 codec. It is the most widespread codec, and he advised to use this. H.265, it has the advantage that it is a newer codec and the file takes up less space, but it is less compatible with older computers. If you want to go to it is safe, select H.264. In encoder you can select native or use NVIDIA if you have a graphics card of this brand. This does not affect the quality of the video. In resolution, make sure you have the correct resolution of your video. Do not use a lower or higher. In my case it is 4K. In image frequency, put the same one that you have used in the settings of your project. I select 25 frames because I have edited my video at that frame rate. Then in the quality section, I recommend uploading the kilobytes second. We add a zero, or you can also put it in automatic and select the maximum quality. Both are good options. Finally, we click on the advanced settings section. Here I recommend activating the option of force sizing to highest quality. If you have used videos of different resolutions in your project. For example, imagine that all the video of Luguana you have recorded in a 4K resolution. But just this clip you recorded in 1080p because you used another camera. In that case you would have to convert this clip from 1080p to 4K. Check that box makes that conversion to 4K at maximum. Audio quality, select the AAC or PCM codec if it allows it. And in sample rate, make sure it is at maximum. We are done. Now click on Add to Render Queue. We see that the project has been added to the queue. We would only have to give render and it would start exporting the video. But first, if you want to save all the settings that we have modified and not change these settings over and over again, simply click on these three points and select Save as New Preset. We choose a name for this setting. And we see that it has created a new setting for us. This way it saves you its time to change all the parameters every time you want to export a video. In case you want to export different versions of the video, for example another version but with the H.265 codec, give the file a different name and add it to the processing queue. We already have the two videos in queue. Now I am going to add another, but with a resolution of 1080p. So, we change the name again and add in queue. Now with several videos added in queue, we can select one and render only that one. or you can also select all three and render all, so you don't have to export video by video. And that would be it. Now just click on the render button and DaVinci Resolve would start working. We go to the desktop and as we can see, we have our three videos exported. Last, if you want to export your video without losing anything for quality, I recommend you use this format, MXFOP1A, in codec, DNXHR, and in type select, 444 12 bits or 444 10 bits. But I already warn you that the final file will be 20 times bigger than H.264 video, so keep this in mind. Thank you very much for watching the video, and that's all. See you in the next video.